Good morning, everyone. On behalf of Indian Business and Professional Council, a warm welcome to all of you. Today's session is on Indian Union Budget, convened by AAA Focus Group. To begin with the session, may I invite Mr. Naveen Sharma, Head of AAA Focus Group, for the opening remarks. A big round of applause, and please welcome Mr. Naveen Sharma.
Good morning. I am in Dubai for the past 22 years and seen the last 22 budgets, but never felt the budget is so relevant for NRIs, so what we have seen this year. From as soon as the finance minister completed her speech, for the next 4-5 hours, there was a complete chaos. I never received so many calls from Gulf News, Khaleej Times, and other publications, that they want to know the story, they want to cover the story. Whether we have to pay the tax, people start thinking, whether should I have the Indian passport, change my passport. A lot of things happened, as if we were all in India. Do you agree? In this background, Indian, thereafter, clarification thereafter, and more or less it is settled, but before I go, before I complete and invite our speaker, let me thank the ICAI chairman, CA Anish Mehta, who is instrumental for arranging the speakers today. Our speaker today, Dr. Girish Ahuja, is on the move. Every day he is in a different country or a different city. I have seen from the various WhatsApp group that he has address in Hyderabad, Delhi. Yesterday, one of the largest gathering in Grand Hyatt of the CA Institute, where 750 members and guests attended. Then he has a plan to go to Kuwait. Every year, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India in India is hosting him for his budget comment. And I would like to thank Anish, who has helped us in bringing this speaker of his caliber to us. Dr. Girish Ahuja, no introduction is required, he is so well known, but I will say a few words. Although the detailed profile is already circulated, he is PhD, Doctor, BCom, MCom, and Chartered Accountant. He passed in 1970, and thereafter he is devoted his life, I can say, for the direct taxation. He has the experience, which is, I can say, no one has the authority as far as the direct tax is concerned than Dr. Girish Ahuja. Before the meeting start, he said, what shall I say to the audience? I said, sir, income tax, direct tax, budgets is in your blood. There is no need. You can answer the questions. You can address the budget, what you feel is relevant from the NRI and non-NRI both side. And I will not take much of your time because we have very limited time, honestly, 1 hour, because he has to address one more gathering thereafter session. So I will waste no time and invite Dr. Girish Ahuja to come on the podium and address all of us. Give a big round of applause.
CA Naveen Sharma, IBPC chairman, of course, and he is the past chairman of Dubai chapter of ICAI also. CA Anish Mehta, the present chairman of the Dubai chapter of ICAI. Ladies and gentlemen, I fail to understand why this chaos is there in that section 6, which we are talking about residential status. Let me tell you, the history is different. You have no idea to touch those people who have come from India, settled here, making good money, but investing that money in India. We are not saying anything to them. Probably it has been mistaken. Rather, we respect them. We respect them. They have done hard work by coming to leaving their country, coming here, settling down, working for others, and sending the money to the country. Nowhere we wanted to touch it. The only difficulty is this country, the law is, you are not liable to tax in this country. You are not liable to tax. The judgments were given against you at one particular point of time. You are not liable does not mean that you were not taxable in this country, But you are not liable, they have given you a sort of exemption. So there is absolutely no problem. But many cases went up, and Sadiq case judgment, Supreme Court said, no, they are not liable to pay tax. We can't say that the tax is there, but they have been given exemption there. Like when you deposit a non-resident external account, you are liable to tax in India, but a separate section has given you exemption of interest on account of money lying in non-resident external account. You are liable to tax, but exemption can be given under a particular section. And that section is section 10(4)A, you get the exemption. So this was the view which was they wanted, that they are liable, but they have been given exemption. He said, no, there is no tax in this country, so you are not liable to pay tax. This is the history when it started. Let me tell you what happened then. People are taking, the Indian citizen, they are now very rich, are taking a lot of money from India. Lot of money has gone. By good means or bad means, by foul means, I will not say. Lot of money is kept at Swiss Bank. Lot of money is kept outside India, in Cayman Island, maybe in Ireland, maybe in tax havens country. Where from they have taken the money? They have taken the money from India. Taken the money there, enjoying life there, but are not paying tax in that country. They are not paying tax in that country. And what has happened? Our money, which is Indian people money, you have earned there. And after earning that money, you want to leave this country saying that there is a lot of corruption in India. How have you taken the money? You have taken the money by way of corruption also many times. And you are criticizing the India that there is a corruption in India. How? Where is the money in Swiss Bank kept? Is it not a corruption money? Where the money in these called Cayman Island, Ireland, America, tax haven country, is all corruption money. Money laundering has been done there. And you say India is a corrupt country. India is not corrupt. The people sitting there who have left this country are basically corrupt. I'm not talking about you people, with my apology. I have been recently nominated by the Supreme Court to the board of directors of, they have taken over UNITEC. UNITEC is a very big company in Delhi, particularly. There's a lot of projects are there. What have they done? 4,300 crore, they took away that money and they gave the money as loan to subsidiaries in Cayman Island. Subsidiaries in Cayman Island. And after that, they have written off that amount of 4,300 crore, not recoverable. Whose money is this? 4,300 crore. Either the flat owners, the one who applied for it, or the bank's money. You are enjoying life, taking away the money from here, enjoying in Cayman Island. The money which you have earned, you might have earned money there, but you are not paid tax, neither there in that country, nor India. What kind of a money is this? You have seen people taking away a lot of money. Gone are the days when it was brought to India. These days, India is very rich. It is taken away from India by them. This is not done. Ruchi Soya industry. Luckily, I'm also there on their board now. It has been taken over Baba Ramdev. Baba Ramdev had taken over the Ruchi Soya industry. 6,000 crore bogus billing and money has been taken to a country outside India. Whose money is this, sir? It is India's money. It is the bank money. And whose bank money is this? Our money in the bank. You also have deposited in the bank. Our money in the bank. What kind of a law is this? You're taking away the money from this country and you are not paying any tax in foreign country. We are not touching those people who are paying tax in foreign country. You are going to tax haven country, avoiding the payment. Earlier the British took away the money from India. Now the Indians themselves are taking away the money from India and enjoying life, not paying tax, neither in India on that income, nor outside India. We were basically concerned with those people. With those people. The same, it is a global problem. It is not an Indian problem, please. The US also, it happened like that. US, what happened? Now the law is in US, if you are a citizen of US, or you are holding a green card of US, you shall be deemed to be resident of US. Even if you don't stay one day in US, even if you don't stay one day US, you have to pay tax in US on the global income. Global income, no question of any treaty. We have a treaty with India. Is there nothing doing? Whatever tax they have paid in a foreign country, we will give them credit, but we will tax them the global income. The global income. And we don't want you to be here. If you want to hold citizenship of US or if you want to hold a green card, you have to pay tax in this country. This is a new law which has happened there. You must have heard about FATCA. हम तो उसको फटका नहीं कहते, फटका कहते हैं. फटकार का फटका हुआ ये. फटका फटकार से बना है. फटका लग गया. Everyone has to share information to US. Even talk about Apple. Apple was paying very minuscule amount of tax in US. Their base was Ireland. Their base was Ireland and not paying any tax because they are a taxable country. Told them, look here, you have to shift your entire establishment to this country. Otherwise, leave this country. They're talking about Apple. Please leave this country. Please leave this country. We are not interested in you. But we are giving a concession. The rate of corporate tax in USA was reduced. Only for that extent, but we will tax you, we will not spare you. This is the position. I'll tell you about that history also, but there is one other history also, 120 days. I'll tell you that also. There is a section called Section 6-1. Those who are chartered accountant can appreciate that particular time of time when they were taking the examination. They had remembered that, now they have forgotten that. Of residential status of an individual, it is Section 6-1. It says, an individual said to be resident in India, if he has been in India for 182 days or more in the relevant previous year. The moment you are in India for 182 days, you are resident. And if you don't satisfy that condition, the second condition says, or in the four preceding previous years, immediately preceding the relevant previous year, you should be in India for 365 days or more. And in the relevant previous year, just 60 days or more. If you are not covered under one, you may be covered under two. 365 days in the four preceding and 60 days. The moment you are a resident in India, you have to pay tax on the global income. A resident has to pay tax on the global income, saying three types of incomes are taxable in case of resident. Income which is received in India or deemed to be received in India, income which accrue or rise in India or deemed to accrue or rise in India, and third income is income which accrue or rise outside India. Pay tax on the global income. You will be liable to pay tax. If you happen to be non-resident, we are asking two types of taxes. Received in India, deemed to be received in India, accrue or rise in India, or deemed to accrue or rise. We are not asking for the tax for the third item. Income which accrue or rise outside India. We are not taxing you. At a particular point of time, 60 days limit. Now the person wants to leave that country for employment abroad. You also must have left the country for employment abroad. The 60-day stay was a very minuscule thing, very, very important, small amount. But you had to leave the country on 29th May. The moment you stay here for 30th May onwards, you were considered to be resident for that year. And considering resident for that year means you will have to pay tax of that year, which you have earned in outside India, in India also. I'll explain. 365 days, had they been permanently in India? 60 days means 30th April, 29 days, 29 May, it is 59. The moment you are there till 30th or onwards, you are citizen. You are a resident and you will have to pay tax on the foreign income which you are going to earn in that previous year. So we gave a concession that a citizen of India who leaves India for employment abroad or for setting a business abroad, the period of 60 days shall be substituted by 182 days. That means you could live in India for 181 days, even if you are there back 365 days. We will not call you resident of that country. And since you will not call resident of that country, you can leave up to in September without being called a resident, and you will not have to pay tax on the foreign income which you are going to earn in that previous year. That was the law. That was the law. We gave the concession to them for employment abroad. 181. And the moment you are there for 182 days, then what is the need of saying back 365 days? You come under condition number one. You come under condition number one if you are there for 182 days. So the concession was given those who are leaving the country for employment. All of you left the country at one particular time, and they were given this benefit. In that particular year, you will not be called resident, you will remain non-resident, and you will not pay any tax which you are going to earn in that previous year in foreign country. Clear? The question came up long back, I'm telling you, that many citizens, Indian citizens, have settled abroad. And they said, sir, we also have a love for our country. We would also love to come and have some business here. We'll love to come have some assets here. So, but the moment we stay here for 60 days, even you become resident. We want to come to this country. This issue was raised by Mr. Swaraj Paul long back, I'm telling you. Swaraj Paul started living in London. Mrs. Gandhi was so-called sister of Swaraj Paul those days. He requested the madam that I am in US, I am earning a lot of money, but I have certain establishment in India also. I would like to grow that business in India also, but I cannot stay here for more than 59 days if I happen to be there for 365 days in the four preceding previous year. But I will bring a lot of money. I'll bring a lot of things here. Why can't you increase that date? 60 days were raised to 90 days, right? Thereafter, 90 days were raised to 150 days. And thereafter, 150 days were raised to 182 days. We gave a concession to citizen of India or person of Indian origin. Citizen means who still hold the passport of India. Or person of Indian origin, those don't have the passport in India, either they have taken citizenship of country or they were born outside India, but their parents or grandparents were born in undivided India. We gave them the concession, you are person of Indian origin. Means either you have taken the citizenship of foreign country. If you have not taken the citizenship of foreign country, what you are? You, either you or your parents or your grandparents were born in undivided India. You have sentiments for India. Come and stay here for 181 days. Establish business here. Bring money here. Do business here. We will not call you resident in India. And the moment you are not called resident in India, whatever the income you are earning in a country outside India will not be taxable in India. Good cause. Good cause. Many things, many people came to India. At that time, India wanted money. At that time, India wanted money. India wanted to grow. And we wanted our citizens. We wanted our person of Indian origin who has sentiments for India. Come and stay here for 181 days. We'll not say anything. But this is now being misused. I'm not talking about you. I'll tell you the other. Now, many people of Indian have taken away the citizen, whatever they earned from India, to country outside India. And established a lot of things outside India, purchased many villas outside India, done very business outside India. Earlier, they were bringing the money. Now, they are taking away the money from India and settling abroad just to avoid payment of tax in India. If you are taking with good, proper channel, we are not saying. Because non-resident these days can take away $1 million without any permission required. You can take more than that also, but that permission is required of Reserve Bank of India. We gave you free convertibility, revenue convertibility. Aiye, jaiye, aur bahar bhi kaam kariye, yahan bhi kaam kariye. Lekin misuse karne ke liye nahi di thi. We never gave you to misuse that thing. Now you are earning money from India, maybe due to quotas, maybe Inspector Raj, maybe for any other reason, maybe political reason, and money is being now taken from India to a foreign country. And you still remain not what you call non-resident. This is not done. Now you are earning money outside India, and that money is not earned outside India, that money was earned from India. This is not done. Now we are rich. Now we have matured. Now we are not less than US also. We are going to think of 5 trillion economy. You are misusing us. Genuine people, we are still not saying anything. You can do whatever you like, but don't tell me that you will take away the money and enjoy there and will not pay tax in either country. Agreed? Now, this issue I'll take up later. I'm closing here to explain it to you. I'll take up later. I'm taking issue now, which is problem created for all of you people. Now, there are many people who have taken away the money from here and settled in a place where there is no tax. There is no tax, Cayman Island, tax haven country. They have taken the money not by good means only. That money laundering has been done from India. I tell you, trillions of dollars have gone from India, kept at Swiss Bank or many other places. They are using the money of India. Britisher took away at one particular time. Now our Indians are taking away. This is not done. Then we got the clue from US. And this is a global problem. This is a global problem because other countries also, they are settling in the tax haven country, not paying tax. So we said here, yeah, now we are matured. We are putting an restriction and we have introduced a clause called Clause 1A in Section 6. Please read, catch my statement, will help you a lot. Particularly, the chartered accountant immediately samajh jayenge. Kya kehta hai? Notwithstanding anything contained under Section 6.1. Notwithstanding means, might have been said in Section 6.1, 182 days. Might have been said in Section 6.1, 4 years, 365 days, and the current year 60, which were raised to 182 days. Might have said, but it is not applicable with you. Wording is notwithstanding anything contained under Section 6.1, a citizen of India, I'm not talking about person of Indian origin, a citizen of India shall be deemed to be a resident of India. Wording is, citizen of India shall be deemed to be a resident in India if is not liable to pay tax in other country, in a foreign country, due to his domicile, due to his residence, due to any criteria of similar nature. We are saying, due to your residence of that country, you are not paying tax in that country. Due to your domicile, you are not paying in that country. And you are also not paying tax in India on that money. Because you are non-resident at one time. Because you don't stay in India for more than 181 days. Look here, you are a resident. You may not have come to India even for one day. You may not have come to India for one day. You are deemed a resident. And deemed resident means you will have to pay tax on the foreign income which you are earning outside India. Pay tax here. Pay tax here because you are not liable to pay tax there. And whose money is this? Our money you have taken. Hum nahi chhodenge, tax yahan dijiye. Shor mach gaya. Mach gaya. Kyunki keh rahe hain, days are not important. You are deemed resident. Lekin word kya hai? You are not liable to pay tax in that country. If you are already liable to pay tax in that country, then you don't fall under this. Then you don't fall under this. But the problem is UAE or Gulf country have been not paying tax in this country. So suddenly I got 300, 400, 500 call when we are doing a webinar on first at the institute level. What kya kara diya, sir? Ye aapke hote ho gaya. Maine kaha mujhe kyun hota ho gaya? Kehta aapne to I redrafted the income. This is the first time in the history of the government of India they took 3% from outside the bureaucrats. And I was one of them to redraft the law. We said, yes, this is a good law. Aapne karaya hai. Main humne nahi karaya hai. Sir, hum phas jayenge. Maine kaha rukiye. Koi nahi phasenge. Kyunki hamari UAE se treaty hai. Double taxation treaty. And treaty overrides the Indian law. Treaty always overrides the law. Hamara law ye kehta hai ki aap citizen hai. A citizen is a resident. Lekin agar Dubai mein ya UAE mein aap resident hain to do jagah ke resident ho gaye. Am I right or wrong? Do gaye na? You happen to be a resident of Dubai or UAE and you also happen to be a resident of Delhi due to what? Deemed case. You may not have gone there at all. You may not have gone there at all. Still, you are a deemed resident. तो क्या हुआ? दो जगह के रेजिडेंट हुए. क्या हुआ जब न्यूजीलैंड और हमारा इंडिया का मैच हो रहा था तो टाई हो गया. हुआ ना टाई. एंड वी हैव वन टाई बाय टाई ब्रेकर टू मैचेस रिसेंटली T20. देखा था ना आपने. व्हाट वाज द टाई ब्रेकर रूल? प्ले वन मोर ओवर, वी कॉल इट द सुपर ओवर. हूएवर स्कोर्स द मोस्ट विल बी द विनर. बट सपोज इन द सुपर ओवर ऑल्सो द सेम थिंग हैपन्स. प्ले वन मोर, प्ले वन मोर टिल फाइनली डिसाइडेड हु इज द Can't be both of you. Cannot be winner. Yeah, one has to be winner. Both cannot be winner. One has to be winner. In your case also, this has happened. You are a resident. Resident of this country. You are a deemed resident of India. Deemed resident of India. Even if you don't go one day, let us apply tiebreaker rule. And there is a tiebreaker rule in Article 3 of the agreement. The tiebreaker says, if you are resident of both the countries, then we will see where you are having permanent home. If you are having permanent in Delhi, India, and you are not having permanent here, then we will call you resident of Delhi or India. But if you are having permanent of both the places, here also, there also, then we call you tied, again tied, match tied. Let's go to the second case. You are having permanent home there also, here also, no problem. Where do you have vital interest? Where do you have economic interest? If you have vital interest here in UAE, or you don't have so much vital interest, where is the biggest? Then you are resident of Dubai. You will not be a resident of India where you have vital interest. Your economic interest to a great extent is in this country. You are remitting the money. Wait a minute. You are remitting the money, but you are earning money from here, sending money there, you have lot of vital economic interest. But come what may, let's say even if you have a vital interest, both places, or maybe a little more in India, don't bother. Let's go to the third tiebreaker. The third tiebreaker says, where your habitual abode, where is your habitual abode? What is your habitual abode? That's all. You are a citizen, you are a resident of UAE. You are not a resident of India. And once you are not a resident of India, you don't have to pay tax on the total on the income which accrue or rise outside India. हमने आपको कुछ कहा ही नहीं. आप ऐसे घबरा गए. हमने क्या कहा है? एक ही गारंटी है कि यू आर रेजिडेंट ऑफ UAE ओनली वेन यू हेयर इन इंडिया, सॉरी हेयर इन UAE फॉर मिनिमम 183 डेज. यू आर हेयर इन दिस कंट्री फॉर 183 डेज. हमने आपको कुछ कहा ही नहीं है. आप परेशान मत होइए, क्योंकि आप रेजिडेंट यूए के भी बन जाएंगे, आप रेजिडेंट इंडिया के तो है ही. हमने तो ले लिया पासपोर्ट, ले लिया, आपका रेजिडेंट है. लेकिन 183 डेज, द मोमेंट यू आर हियर, वी आर नॉट सेइंग एनीथिंग टू यू. वी विल नॉट चार्ज एनी इनकम ऑन द इनकम विच यू आर अर्निंग इन अ कंट्री आउटसाइड इंडिया. तो हमने क्या कहा आपको? क्यों नाराज हैं आप हमसे? हम तो आपसे बिल्कुल नाराज नहीं है. आप जैसा लोग तो हम वेलकम करते हैं. हम तो चाहते हैं ऐसे लोग हों जिसका इंडिया के साथ सेंटीमेंट्स है. वो चाहते हैं कि पैसा यहाँ कमा कर इंडिया में इन्वेस्ट करें. हम तो आपको वेलकम कर रहे हैं. ये कंट्री को बढ़ाया ही आप लोगों ने, लेकिन आप वहाँ से कुछ लेके नहीं आए थे. देते हैं हम उनको पकड़ रहे हैं जो वहाँ से लेकर आकर और कहाँ जा रहे हैं? केमैन आइलैंड में, आयरलैंड में चले गए और टैक्स हेवन कंट्री. उनको क्यों छोड़ा जाए बताइए? क्यों छोड़ा जाए उनको? या तो वहां टैक्स दें, अगर वहां टैक्स दे तो इंडिया में टैक्स दे फॉरन इनकम. पर हम तो ये कह रहे हैं, हमने तो कुछ कहा ही नहीं. और ये ग्लोबल प्रॉब्लम है. इवन यूएस इज सेइंग आल्सो दिस, इवन द अदर कंट्रीज आल्सो, यू वेट फॉर 1/4/2020 मल्टी लेयर इंस्ट्रूमेंट आ रहे हैं, वहां भी यही होगा सबका. कोई नहीं छोड़ा जाएगा जो सोचेगा मैं टैक्स चोरी कर लूं. ये चोरी की है, क्योंकि आपने उस कंट्री में एडवांटेज लेकर, टैक्स हेवन कंट्री लेकर आपने अपना डोमिसाइल वहां बना लिया, आपने अपना रेजिडेंशियल स्टेटस वहां क्रिएट कर लिया और ऐश कर रहे हैं. ये नहीं होगा, ये नहीं होगा. हम आपको कुछ नहीं कह रहे. अब कोई कहता है, सर मेरे को अभी भी कहा, सर हम 183 डेज में रहते नहीं हैं क्योंकि हमें घूमना पड़ता है, इधर ही यूएई में भी बाहर भी जाना पड़ता है. देखिए मैं एक चीज बताऊं, आप अपनी कंट्री को भी कह सकते हैं ये वाली को, ये 183 डेज को जरा कम कर दे, 150 कर दे, एग्रीमेंट ही तो है। अगर वो 150 कर देंगे तो फिर आप तो 215 दिन बाहर रह सकते हैं। ये डिमांड तो आप कर सकते हैं, क्यों नहीं कर सकते? हमने तो करा ही था डिमांड, ये आपको 182-191 दे दिया। थोड़ी सी तो डिमांड है कि ट्रीटी में 183 डेज लिखा है, इफ दे ब्रिंग इट डाउन टू 150 आई थिंक इट विल बी सफिशिएंट। और इतना भी रहेंगे तो फिर वो कहते हैं हमारे पास क्यों रह रहे हो, इतने दिन तो दुबई में रहो। और हो सकता है हम कुछ और भी FAQs लाएं, हो सकता है हम लिख दें कि जो इम्प्लॉयमेंट अगर यहाँ पर है, ड्यू टू इम्प्लॉयमेंट ही माइट हैव टू ट्रेवल, शायद वो दिन मान लीजिए। लेट अस सी, दैट इज अ प्रपोज वी आर सजेस्टिंग, बट लेट मी टेल यू, you people are not affected. We have a treaty with Kuwait, we have a treaty with Qatar, we have a treaty with, of course, Oman also, but unfortunately we don't have a treaty with Bahrain, because we were looking for it, has not materialized till to date. Exchange of information is there, but there is no treaty in Bahrain. We are well concerned of that, our people in Bahrain. We are thinking of that, either we will go immediately for treaty or we will come out some rules where they are not affected. They will not be affected. I'm telling you, we are very concerned of our Indians who have love for India. We are concerned for those who do not have a love for India, sirf dikhane ke liye karte hain ki India mein to corruption hai, India mein to pollution hai, India mein to ye hai, to tum kahan se paida hue the aur tum kahan se wahan chale gaye, ab aapko lagta hai India bekar hai? Are yaar, ye to achhi baat nahi, apni matrabhumi ko kehte hain bekar hai, तो पैदा ही नहीं होना था वहां पर। अरे यार, ये तो गलत बात है सर। लेट अस नॉट क्रिटिसाइज अवर कंट्री, लेट अस नॉट क्रिटिसाइज अवर कंट्री बिकॉज यू आर टेकन अवे मनी फ्रॉम द कंट्री। आई एम नॉट सेइंग, इफ यू आर ब्रिंगिंग द मनी टू अवर कंट्री, वी आर रियली ओबलाइज्ड एंड वी विल रिमेन ओबलाइज्ड। इट डज नॉट मीन आप वहां से चोरी करके पैसा ले जाएं, मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग करें, बेनामी प्रॉपर्टी बाहर क्रिएट कर लें, ट्रस्ट वहां पर बना लें और पैसा एक भी इंडिया में दे। अब तो वो फंस जाएंगे ना, वो भी तो बताता हूँ, क्योंकि अगर आप रेजिडेंट हैं तो आपको अपनी कंप्लीट डिटेल देनी पड़ती है ऑफ ऑल फाइनेंशियल इंटरेस्ट इन ए कंट्री आउटसाइड इंडिया, पूरा फाइनेंशियल इंटरेस्ट, पूरे एसेट्स आउटसाइड इंडिया, पूरी पूरे जो बेनिफिशियरी इंटरेस्ट है आउटसाइड इंडिया, और देना पड़ेगा। और देते ही गलत होगा तो ब्लैक मनी एक्ट लग जाएगा, और ब्लैक मनी एक्ट में सीधा जेल है 10 साल। इंडिया छोड़ेगा नहीं इन लोगों को, और छोड़ना भी नहीं चाहिए। और ये मोदी जी का जमाना है, पहले छोड़ देते थे, लेकिन मोदी जी के टाइम पे ब्लैक मनी एक्ट आया, मोदी जी के टाइम पे बेनामी लॉ एक्ट आया, मोदी जी के टाइम में ही कई चेंजेस हुई। सो व्हाई शुड दे बी लेफ्ट, व्हाई शुड दे वी स्पेयर देम, दे हैव टेकन अवे अवर मनी, गो एंड स्टे देयर, ब्रिंग बैक अवर मनी, वी विल नॉट से एनीथिंग टू यू। हम कह रहे हैं मेरा पैसा तो लेके गए हुए हो, बैंका को ले गए, बैंकों का ले गए, हमारा ले गए, फ्लैट ओनर्स का ले गए, फ्लैट बायर्स का ले गए, बेचारों ने जोड़ जोड़ कर पैसा जोड़ा और बैंकों से भी लोन लिया और दे के रख दिया और वो लेके भाग गए। एक नहीं भागे, बहुत भागे। हाँ जी सर, ये हो गया जो बाहर टैक्स नहीं देते उस कंट्रीज में है वेयर देयर इज नो लायबिलिटी ऑफ टैक्स। ये आपके लिए वो डीम्ड रेजिडेंट है, बाकियों को हमने डीम्ड रेजिडेंट बोला ही नहीं। If you are paying tax in London or US, you are paying tax in London, you are paying tax in foreign countries, Singapore, you are paying tax in Hong Kong, you are paying tax in Germany, we are not saying anything to you. I'm coming to that. They have started.
They started like 7-8 years.
Income tax. Individual.
1% income tax.
Individual.
1%.
I was told they have no tax in there.
7-8 years.
Let us see. The VAT has come there. इनकम टैक्स दे आर सेइंग लेट मी चेकअप, होगा तो हम रिलीफ दे देंगे, हम रिलीफ दे देंगे, फिर तो दिक्कत नहीं है। सुनिए, अब दीज पीपल हु वर पेइंग टैक्स इन कंट्री आउटसाइड इंडिया, हमने उनको भी रिस्ट्रिक्शन लगा दी है, दे आर मिस यूजिंग, अर्लियर वी वॉन्टेड देम। अब क्या है, पैसा यहाँ से लेकर फिर भी 181 डेज इंडिया में रहते हैं। ये ललित मोदी और नीरव मोदी और वॉट यू कॉल गोयल or many other have taken lot of money to country outside India. They may be paying tax in that country, I'm not saying. They may be paying tax. But now these type of people are misusing and staying in India for 181 days every year without being called a resident. Hum kyun unko pakadna chahte hain ki jitni foreign assets hai na usko batao hame, wo nahi batate. We are saying, tell us what kind of assets you have abroad. Aapke apne asset create kiye, hum mana thodi kar rahe hain. Lekin India se money laundering kar li, India se paisa leke benami property create kar li, hum aapko ab allow karenge India mein, but not more than 119 days. Well, 182 days tha, now it is 120 days. 120 days means we had recommended 90 days. They said, let us not do that fast. You can stay in India. I'm not talking about you. Aap to jab marji thehriye. 183 yahan par hain. India mein jaake 182 bhi thehre, hum kuch nahi kahenge. Kyunki aap to deemed hai resident. Aap bas samjha resident ki aap to deemed resident. Aapko to lagne nahi 6 months. You stay in 183 days. Come to India for any period. Bhai maximum to 365 din hai. To kitna rehle? Aa jaiye. Bana di kar. Aapko kuch nahi keh rahe. Unko keh rahe jahan taxable country mein rehte hain, jahan tax lagta hai. Please, if you want to stay in India, maximum 119 days. Maximum 119 days. The reason, I'll tell you why. In our country, if you're a resident in India, resident are of two types. We remember those days when you were studying. Resident and ordinarily resident in India. Resident but not ordinarily resident in India. What is the difference between the two? You are a resident. But ordinarily resident means you have been living a resident of the country for ages, not ordinarily resident. The difference between the two is, if you are a resident, you are liable to pay tax on the foreign income also in India. But if you are not ordinarily resident, you will have to pay tax on the foreign income only when it is from a business which is controlled from India, or it is from a profession which is set up in India. हम बाकी पे नहीं करते, हम हाउस सैलरी पे टैक्स नहीं करते जो बाहर है, हाउस प्रॉपर्टी पे नहीं करते. अ बिजनेस अब्रॉड विच इज कंट्रोल्ड फ्रॉम इंडिया, बोर्ड मीटिंग वहीं हो रही है और कह रहे हैं कि कंट्रोल्ड फ्रॉम इंडिया है तो उसको टैक्स कर लेंगे अगर आप नॉट ऑर्डिनरी भी होंगे. और ये प्रोफेशन है, इंडिया में आपने प्रोफेशन सेटअप किया हुआ है, लेकिन लॉयर है, बहुत बड़ी कंपनी है, लेकिन वहां पर आप सर्विस रेंडर कर रहे हैं तो कर लेंगे, बाकी नहीं, बाकी नहीं. नॉट ऑर्डिनरी. ऑर्डिनरी तो बड़ा सिंपल हो गया, नॉट ऑर्डिनरी. पहले नॉट ऑर्डिनरी बनने के लिए कुछ कंडीशन थी. अर्लियर द कंडीशन वॉज यू शुड बी नॉन रेजिडेंट, क्योंकि रेजिडेंट बनने के लिए तो करंट ईयर देखा, अब नॉट ऑर्डिनरी के क्या देख रहे. यू शुड बी नॉन रेजिडेंट इन 9 out of 10 प्रीवियस ईयर्स इमीडिएटली प्रिसीडिंग द रेलेवेंट प्रीवियस. हाउ मेनी टाइम नॉन रेजिडेंट? 9 times. One year you can be resident. Then there was a second condition, and in the 7 preceding previous year you should not be in India for more than 729 days. For more than 729 days. Log kya karte the, har saal 100 din aa jaate the, 700 din hue. Aur pehli condition set, dono condition satisfy karni padti thi. Yahi nahi satisfy hui to pehle dekhte hi nahi the. 9 out of 10 था ना, 9 out of 10 प्लस 729 डेज था. तो आप क्या करें, 700 रह जाएं और उधर वो जो रेजिडेंट भी हो गए 9 more than 1, तो फर्क नहीं पड़ता था, दोनों कंडीशन सेटिस्फाई करनी पड़ती थी. 729 दिन भी और 9 out of 10. अब हमने रिलैक्स कर दिया उनको, वी हैव रिलैक्स देम. व्हाट इज द रिलैक्सेशन? लुक हियर, यू कैन बी नाउ नॉन रेजिडेंट इन 7 out of 10 प्रीवियस. Not resident. That means if you are resident for 3 years also, we are still calling you not ordinarily resident. Benefit de diya na. Pehle to 1 saal tha. Ab 3 saal tak resident ho sakte hai. Aur hum aapko not ordinary manenge. Aur not ordinary mante hi, income which accrue arise outside India from a business which is set up in, controlled from India, or profession set up in India, that only will be taxable. The other income will not be. ये रिलैक्स कर दिया, आओ, हम मना नहीं कर रहे, लेकिन हमारे ही बिजनेस का कमाओगे तो यहां देके जाओगे, क्योंकि बिजनेस कहां से कंट्रोल कर रहे हो, यहां पे कंट्रोल कर रहे हो. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? अदरवाइज हमने कोई फॉरेन इनकम को टैक्स नहीं किया. वी आर नॉट टचिंग दैट फॉर, दीज आर फॉर दोस हु आर पेइंग टैक्स इन दैट कंट्री. ये आपके लिए नहीं है. हु आर पेइंग टैक्स इन ए फॉरेन कंट्री, they can come and stay in India maximum 3 years as resident out of the 10. The moment you cross 3, then they will become resident and ordinarily resident, and they will have to pay tax on the global income. लेकिन हमने कितना रिलैक्स कर रखा है. सुनिए, अगर आप नॉन रेजिडेंट हैं और यू आर रेजिडेंट बट नॉट ऑर्डिनरी रेजिडेंट, यू डू नॉट हैव टू प्रोवाइड अस द इंफॉर्मेशन द एसेट्स एंड द फाइनेंशियल इंटरेस्ट यू हैव आउटसाइड इंडिया. तो हम आपको कह रहे हैं, हम आपको कुछ तंग नहीं कर रहे, लेकिन रेजिडेंट एंड ऑर्डिनरी हो जाएंगे तो छोड़ेंगे नहीं. बताओ क्या है आपके पास बात, क्या मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग की है, क्या ले गए हो. तो सर ये क्या बुरा है बताइए. अब मुझे बताइए, अब क्वेश्चन जितने मर्जी पूछिए मैं आपको जवाब दूंगा. फर्स्ट वाज हिज क्वेश्चन. हाँ जी, तो सर माइक लेंगे ना तो बाकियों को पता लगेगा. मैं तो आई है.
आई जस्ट आस्क फर्स्ट
फर्स्ट कम हियर बिकॉज ही वाज द फर्स्ट मैन टू रीच द हैंड.
थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू, अप्रिशिएट इट. थैंक यू.
प्लीज लेट मी नो.
आपने आपने कहा कि ट्रीटी ओवरराइड्स लॉ. अब हमने रिसेंटली देखा कि मॉरिशियस के साथ ट्रीटियां रीनेगोशिएट हुई है मोदी जी के आने के बाद. हाँ, आगे पीछे कंट्रीज में डिफरेंसेस आते हैं, कुछ आते हैं. तो वी पीपल हु हैव जेन्युइनली अर्न मनी ओवर द लास्ट 30-40-50 इयर्स, जो पैसे इंडिया में भेजते हैं, कोई हराम का पैसा नहीं
मिला हुआ.
तो ये लोग जब यहाँ पे रहते हैं और अगले 20 साल 30 साल,
अगर यहाँ पे टैक्स लग गया तो आप तो वैसे ही बच गए.
नहीं, मैं ये कह रहा हूँ कि ये लॉ में क्यों नहीं एज्ड होता है ताकि वी आर सिक्योर.
देखिए 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 देखिए, दिस कंट्री इज अ ग्लोबल प्रॉब्लम है. OECD कंट्रीज है, आपको बता रहा हूँ, वहां पर ये डिस्कशन हो रहा है कि वर्ल्ड ओवर पीपल आर मिसयूजिंग एंड स्टेइंग इन अ प्लेस वेयर देयर इज टैक्स हेवन कंट्री. हम उनको डिस्करेज कर रहे हैं. क्या डिस्करेज कर रहे हैं? लुक हियर, सारी कंट्रियों को बता दिया ये क्या हो रहा था मॉरिशियस में, कि सब कंपनियां मॉरिशियस के थ्रू इंडिया में रूट करती थी इन्वेस्टमेंट. ऑल कंपनी लेटर बॉक्स कंपनी, हम उनको लेटर बॉक्स कंपनी कहते थे. वहां कोई एस्टेब्लिशमेंट नहीं, वो एक TRC ले लेते थे, 8,000 रुपए लगते थे और वो वहां पर लेटर बॉक्स कंपनी खुल गई. वहां से इन्वेस्ट किया और हमारी कंट्री में था. कैपिटल गेन विल बी टैक्सेबल इन द कंट्री ऑफ विच दे आर रेजिडेंट. वो रेजिडेंट मॉरिशियस के होते थे और मॉरिशियस में कैपिटल गेन टैक्स था ही नहीं, तो इसलिए बच गए ना. आपने देखा क्या हुआ हमारे यहाँ, वो आजादी बचाओ आंदोलन में हमने सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने कह दिया, हमने उनको कुछ कहा नहीं, लॉ बन गया था. क्योंकि यशवंत सिन्हा थे मुझे याद है उस वक्त, लेकिन हमें पैसे की जरूरत थी.